Well, my artifact and fossil donations for January 10th is horn coral, Devonian period. I will get it out of the bag. Now, this is what I found today on a stream course in the upper tide zone. That is horn coral, Devonian period horn coral. A real nice example of it, too. Yeah. Devonian horn coral. And the next is Ordovian fossil sponge. That was found this afternoon along with the horn coral. Okay, let the camera focus. There's almost this area, fossil sponge, Ordovian period. This is from before fish had cranial bones. This was from the age of invertebrates. Now I would have, just looking at this part here, I would have said, oh, maybe it's possible it's a piece of fossil dinosaur bone. But upon further research, I'd have to say no. This is sponge. The key evidence for the sponge properties would be these here. and there is Ordovian shale. All the way back from the Ordovian period. I think this is in the 500, between 500 and 300 million years old. Maybe even older. Yeah, well, that's Ordovian fossil sponge. That was found today. And now here we have Jurassic clamshell, Jurassic clamshell fossil, one of the Glycymeris genuses. There were 100 of them. Now, at first you might think, oh no, that is just a normal clamshell. But this is about to move it away. This is what told me it was a fossil shell. It's one of the Glycymeris genus shells. That's 140 million years old, something like that. A good portion of shell is there, but so, yeah. It's a miracle a piece this big survived to this day. Here's a rare find. Ordovian Fisheritis Ordovian Fisheritis Reticulatus algae, fossil algae. Now, this part here hinted that it might be an algae, fossil algae, but what's on the other side of it is what really gave it away. Wow. I'll just take it out of the plastic. That is called Fisheritis reticulatus, Ordovian Fisheritis reticulatus algae. And the nice thing about this, the fossil is in such fine condition. It looks like it could come to life. That's a really nice specimen of fossil algae. Alright, well that's enough of that one. Next we have let's turn this package around. Calamite plant seed fern fossil. Calamite seed fern fossil. Carboniferous Permian period plant fossils. But the most important finding that I made today was a woodland period object. Either this is a woodland period gorget or Paleo Eskimo Ulu. Either way, it's a very ancient. It's the remains of one. Stone drill. This was done by bow drill using stone drills attached to wooden shafts. Very ancient. I found this while I was waiting for the camera battery to warm up. The camera was inside my coat. Yep, this is, I'm just guessing, from middle to late woodland period. Anywhere from, I guess, 4,500 to 1,500 years ago. This is my second piece like this. You never know what you're going to find in the mud. It was in a crevice. That front beach ravine is where I found this. Well, that is what will be in my donation bag for January 10th. St. John the Baptist School is going to have the finest collection of fossils and artifacts in the entire school system of New Brunswick. Its science center, put together by those lovely teachers, will be the best in the province. I guarantee you that, because Tin Can Beach is giving up its secrets. From fossil bone to woodland period ornaments to coral fossils, algae fossils, you name it, it's all coming up. And I don't mind rescuing all this from the tide. It's going to the children to study and learn from. I will see you online.